What is good, YouTube? Welcome back to another reaction video, and here we got for you guys today: Sauce Walker Sanchez P Maybach Freestyle. Now, this song has been blowing up for a certain reason now, and it's because he called out my man J. Cole. For some reason, I have no idea why. I don't even know who this dude is. But he called him out. He wants to go toe-to-toe, bar for bar with J. Cole. During the time when J. Cole is like on his little feature phase, right? He's killing every feature right now. So, I don't know if you guys know who this is, but Token, right? The guy I react to on my channel I did 4 weeks ago. That's when I had my last reaction with Token. He's called out J. Cole in the past before as well, when J. Cole was you know, getting relevant again. But let's see what Sauce Walker's talking about, man. So this is a freestyle, so I don't know what the original song is. But we're about to find out, man. So without further ado, let's get straight into the video, man. Of course.
Boy, I wanna do a song with J. Cole too. Song with this ghetto gospel, right? I'm from the streets of no knowledge. Kids dying with books in their hands, ain't no college. Niggas sliming out their best friends they thought was solid for less than a wallet. They feminizing our kings, rappers wearing nail polish just to make their sales rise.
Wait. What'd he say? Hold on, he said something in the beginning that took the cake. Hold on. Let me put on the captions, hold on.
I'm from the streets of no knowledge. Kids dying with books in their hands, ain't no college. Niggas sliming out their best friends they thought was solid for less than a wallet. They feminizing our kings, rappers wearing nail polish just to make they.
Did you guys hear what he just said? I'm from the streets of no knowledge. Kids dying with books in their hands. No college. Yo, the first opening line, bro. Yo, that was crazy. And then he said friends sliming out their friends, like, and that they thought they were silent. So like, you sliming out your own friend that thought that, like, you know, they thought they were silent, they thought they was riding with you, and then like you find out that wasn't the case. And then he's saying that they're feminizing our rappers wearing nail polish. Look at Drake. Look at Lil Yachty. There's a bunch of other people as well. Oh, MGK, because MGK wasn't on that wave before. It's crazy. That was crazy. I gotta go back for that.
I'm from the streets of no knowledge. Kids dying with books in their hands, ain't no college. Niggas sliming out their best friends they thought was solid for less than a wallet. They feminizing our kings, rappers wearing nail polish just to make their sales rising. I thought you was a man. I thought you was the leader in this world against the clan. I guess you just another monkey with a switch in your hand. Let me hand you a banana so you can kill your best friend.
No, bro, I'm not gonna get through this video in time, bro. If this is about to be a long video, he's saying that I thought you was a leader. I thought you was a man. I thought you was trying to rival against the clan. Basically, we all know what clan he's talking about. And then he said you're just a monkey with a handgun. Basically, you're just a monkey with a weapon. Let me give you a banana so you could kill your best friend, bro. Listen, that little scheme right there was fire. He's talking. He's literally talking right now. He's talking.
I thought you was the leader in this world against the clan. I guess you just another monkey with a switch in your hand. Let me hand you a banana so you can kill your best friend. Could have been your best man. Nigga look just like you. But because you rep another hood, the nigga wanna fight you. Could have made a team and won a ring when Pippen met Michael. But
yeah.
We hate our own brothers. It's a never ending cycle. We kill our own stars. We'd rather see a nigga catch a busting on cars. It's It's hard to love success when you struggle so hard. Imagine doing 40 years behind them cold bars. You
can Bro, look, yo. And listen, he's not saying nothing new. We like this, and so many people that has come out and said this and like talked about this topic. This isn't nothing new. But the fact that we have to keep going over this, like he said, is an overlapping cycle. We do these things, we talk about it, it goes away for a week, we do it again, goes away for a week. It's an overlapping cycle that will never end if we keep letting this happen. The only time we come together is if it's like another race attacking our race, or if it's like a white person or a white listen. This shouldn't even be the case. Like, the only time we ever come together, if it's a white cop or literally a white person attacking a black person, a black race, that's the only time that we ever truly be together. So, but he said something about success, and it's the struggle. It's hard to see success when you're literally struggling. Your own people, you know, you're literally battling your own people for success. It literally doesn't make any sense.
Kill your best friend, could have been your best man, nigga look just like you, but because you rep another hood, the nigga wanna fight you. Could have made a team and won a ring with Pippen, met Michael, but we hate our own brothers. It's a never ending cycle. We kill our own stars, we rather see a nigga catch a busting on cars. It's hard to love success when you struggle so hard. Imagine
that's what he said. It's hard to love success when you struggle so hard, bro. It's like you can't even think about having all this money or being successful because you're like how you're struggling, like the hand you've been dealt with. It's so hard to climb out of that cave, it's just hard to climb those heights when all you're seeing around you is pain and misery, you know. So like in that type of way I can see what he's talking about. So, but like when people do make it out, it's so hard for them. Like they get so like invested in success and stuff that they kind of get lost in it. And you know that some people is just not built like that.
It's a never ending cycle. We kill our own stars. We rather see a nigga catch a busting on cars. It's hard to love success when you struggle so hard. Imagine doing 40 years behind them cold bars. You completely innocent, but just was at the wrong park.
Exactly.
Find the suspect, all of a sudden you is twin. I only seen the pastors and the hustlers drive ins. Why everybody else high on hope, trying to win. Not my bone, nigga, not my bin. I saw trusting and I...
Oh, the flow. Relax. He was about to go in real quick. Hold on. Oh, man. That situation is like, what he just described, it made me think of Central Park 5 with those five black men. And... yeah, go read up on that situation. That situation is crazy. Yeah, but that just made me think of Central Park 5. You're literally guilty by association. You could literally be minding your own business, and then just some out of nowhere something could just pop off, and then you're the next suspect, and you was just there by some random park. Like, that's literally wild. Oh man, it's funny how that works, huh? Automatically, you become the next suspect because of your skin color.
All of a sudden, you is twin. I only seen the pastors and the hustlers drive ins. Why everybody else high on hope, trying to win? Not my bone, nigga, not my bin. I saw trusting and not right in. Mama on coke ain't chugging no flow, with it ain't no soap but the whole kitchen. Then it ain't broken, it wasn't no show. Why you think the little boy think that's a grown man? Can't even spell, but he wanna spin.
He said you can't even spell, but you wanna be in with the gang, basically. Hold on. I don't know what you call it, but basically the ending word that he was ending with to make it rhyme with each sentence. I'm a dining in the kitchen in. I be tiring in, like that was hard. Listen.
I don't hope, trying to win. Not my bone, nigga, not my fin. I saw trusting and not I did. My ain't chugging no flow and it ain't no soap in the whole kitchen. Daddy ain't broken, it wasn't no show. Why you think the little boy think that's a grown man? Can't even spell, but he wanna spin. In this direction where my people in. Fucking keep rapping about diamonds and hens.
Exactly. See, he want to dine in and then want to kitchen in. He can't even spell, but he want to spin. But he want to spin in that direction. He want to be down with the gang. Yeah. He want to be. He want to be grown in. He want to grow up too fast. You know. But that's just cause he like he. That's just the life he's evolved around. That part reminded me of when that part reminded me of little RT, that 6 year old that was rapping about the whole gang life. Like he's been through everything and all. And yeah, the. I'm only halfway through this video and we're 10 minutes in. This is crazy. But yeah, man. This is wild.
The whole kitchen. Daddy ain't broken. It wasn't no show. Why you think the little boy think that's a grown man? Can't even spell, but he wanna spin. In this direction where my people in. Fucking keep rapping about diamonds and hen. Fucking keep rapping about murders and sin. Fucking keep rapping about scamming again. Better hold body, don't catch you, my friend. Still remember everybody was against Donald Trump. Now Joe Biden up in office, the whole hood broke as fuck. He done fell off a bike, you done fell in a slump. The trap moving slow cause the money dried up. The bricks cheap as hell but the weed high as fuck. Nobody smoking work, they want the side big cups. Them blues be the moves till that fit knowledge test. People die hard bust, now them fans at your nuts. Them robbers get the starving, it's nothing but stick ups. He saw the ring camera still shot him, what the fuck? If God had let this happen, then who can I trust? Nobody but this pistol, that's the reason why it's clutch.
If God let this happen, who is the one that I can trust? I guess it's this pistol then. Wow. Dude, bro. This is heavy. This is heavy, man. Wow.
The side big cups, them blues be the moves till that fit knowledge test. People die hard bust, not them fans at your nuts. The robbers get the starving, it's nothing but stick ups. He saw the ring camera still shot him, what the fuck? If God had let this happen, then who can I trust? Nobody but this pistol, that's the reason why it's clutch. R.I.P. to Mr. Hutch. The jeweler, I'm from the slums where pussy niggas rape high schoolers.
Oh.
Get the gun, crack the act like he never knew her. Finally go to jail and get less time than the shooter.
He just said something, yo, he just said the realest thing I've heard in this freestyle. Not even about the beginning part. He like that ending part when he said that he'll literally get less time than a shooter, than a person that literally nah. Cause it's supposed to be the other way around. This is wild. Oh my God, we gotta hear that again.
I'm from the slums where pussy niggas rape high schoolers. Get the girl pregnant, act like he never knew her. Finally go to jail and get less time than the shooter.
That was wild. So he called out J. Cole for this. Hold on. There's something I gotta see something real quick. This yo. Night. Okay, so that's where J. Cole comes in. He's saying that after he dropped his fantastic freestyle, because this was fantastic, let's be honest. He says that he could go bar for bar with J. Cole after doing this. So that's where the J. Cole like kind of like sneak this, like you know, competition comes in. And I mean, hey, he showed him what he can. He showed us what he can do. So I'm not surprised, but this is crazy. Like this was a masterpiece. Like in terms of saying something like this today is like, that's crazy. He did a great job. Those punchlines was wild though. Man. I gotta clap it up for him because that was amazing. That was amazing. Hey man. This is a 15 minute video, man, but I'm gonna let it rock. And this was only a almost 3 minute song. Yeah. Alright. Guys, man, if you enjoyed this, please like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you guys want to see next in the comments down below. Go to my Patreon where all of my blog reactions will be, with the copyright and blur on the screen. And please turn on your post notifications so you can be notified every time I drop a new video. Because this bang is all 2023 to 2024, man. I promise you guys, you do not want to miss the upcoming videos I have next. And if you want to further support, go down to my Cash App. It is in the link in the description down below. Thank you guys for all the love and support. I appreciate every single one of you guys. And I hope you guys are here to stay. But with that being said, you guys already know this. I'm out of here, man.